TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 3rd of January. Infant death toll rises to over 100 in 1 month in northwestern India. Pakistan's Standing Committee on Defence approves bills on tenure of services chiefs. Dalai Lama holds Kala Chakra teaching session in eastern India. And now for all the details. Infant death toll crossed over 100 in just 1 month at a government-run hospital in Kota city of India's northwestern Rajasthan province, allegedly due to lack of infrastructure. The central government has constituted a multidisciplinary team for gap analysis and ascertaining quick measures.
Since the beginning of December, 100 infants have died in the government-run JK Lawn Hospital in Kota city of India's northwestern Rajasthan province. An official has confirmed. Local media reported 3 more deaths in the first 2 days of 2020, allegedly due to lack of infrastructure and manpower at the hospital. While one of the 3 infants was admitted due to drastic weight loss, the other 2 were transferred from another hospital. Meanwhile, some people were also seen shifting their newborns to other hospitals on Thursday evening as the news spread.
December ki pediatric vibhag ki jo death statistics hai usme 100 mrityu hai jo hamare pediatric vibhag ke HOD mahoday se kal humne collect ki thi suchna.
The federal government has constituted a multidisciplinary team of top pediatricians for gap analysis and ascertaining quick measures. A provincial government committee had earlier found that the hospital is short of beds and its functioning needs improvement, but had cleared the doctors there of any lapses over the deaths.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated the 107th Indian Science Congress in southern Bengaluru city on Friday. Prime Minister Modi called upon scientists to follow 4 steps: innovate, patent, produce and prosper to lead the country towards faster development.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated the 107th Indian Science Congress at University of Agricultural Sciences in southern Bengaluru city on Friday. Prime Minister Modi, who was on a 2-day visit to southern Karnataka province, also launched the Indian Science Technology and Engineering Facilities MAP or iSTEM portal, which is designed to be the gateway for researchers to locate specific type of facility they need for their research and development work in India. Stressing the need to transform the landscape of Indian science, technology and innovation, Prime Minister Modi said the growth story of India depends on its success in science and technology sector.
Friends, the growth story of India depends on its success in the science and technology sector. There is a need to transform the landscape of Indian science, technology and innovation. My motto for the young scientists is, this country is, innovate, patent, produce and prosper.
Prime Minister Modi said India must also develop a long-term roadmap to sustainable and environment-friendly transportation and energy storage options. The 5-day event brings together science fraternity across the world to discuss scientific innovation and research.
In news from Pakistan, the National Assembly and Senate's Joint Standing Committee on Defence on Friday afternoon unanimously approved the 3 bills pertaining to tenure of chiefs of the tri-services. The bills are expected to be presented for approval in the National Assembly on Saturday.
The National Assembly and Senate's Joint Standing Committee on Defense unanimously approved the three bills pertaining to amendments to Pakistan's Army Act, the Navy Act, and the Air Force Act on Friday afternoon. The bills pertaining to the tenure of the three services chiefs will be presented for approval in the National Assembly on Saturday. This came after Pakistan's Federal Minister for Defense Pervez Khattak tabled the three bills in the National Assembly while seeking powers to extend Chief of the Army Staff General Qamar Javed Bajwa's tenure. The bills aim to fix 64 years as the maximum age limit of all three defense chiefs. Pakistan's Supreme Court had last month given the government led by Prime Minister Imran Khan 6 months to set the tenure and other service terms of the Army Chief through an Act of Parliament. The top court had suspended an earlier government decision to extend General Bajwa's term for 3 years, citing procedural loopholes. It, however, granted a temporary 6-month extension to Bajwa's term, which was due to end in late November.
Moving on, residents in Gilgit city of Gilgit-Baltistan have expressed serious concerns over choked drainage systems. Over the last 2 months, overflowing sewage water has disrupted businesses along with routine life in the city.
Residents in Gilgit city of Gilgit-Baltistan have raised serious concerns over choked drainage systems that have led to sewage overflowing on the roads, creating problems for them. They have blamed that it has been around 2 months, but the authorities have paid no heed. The stagnated water on the roads is not only creating traffic chaos, but has also become a breeding ground for waterborne diseases. Some of them complained that the sewage water has also damaged their shops and properties, apart from affecting their businesses and normal life.
Sir, ye pani pichle koi 2 mahino se jama hai. Agar ala hukam kuch tawajjo le to, baki hum kehne mein kya kahein? Ye sare bhai hamare tamashibin ban gaye, gareeb bichare kichad ke upar sawar reh rahe hain 2 mahino se.
Hamari hukumat se, wazir ala se aur ala hukam se appeal karte hain. कि फौरी हमारी जायदाद को बचाया जाए हम इन दुकानों से गुजारा चलाते अपने तो इन ये अभी सारे डैमेज हो गए हैं तो लिहाजा आज पांचवा छठा दिन है कोई टस से मस नहीं है तो आखिर हमारे साथ ये जुल्म क्यों है
रेजिडेंट्स ऑफ गिलगित बल्तिस्तान हैव ऑलरेडी बीन बियरिंग द बर्डन ऑफ कंटामिनेटेड वाटर एंड अनअवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ प्रॉपर ड्रेनेज सिस्टम हैज एग्रेवेटेड देयर वोज Pakistani administration that stakes illegal claim on Gilgit-Baltistan has left the region underdeveloped for decades now.
In news from Afghanistan, Deputy Spokesman for Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, Latif Mahmood, has said that the government has clear stance towards peace talks. He said that peace will only prevail after the Afghan government and the Taliban talk.
Deputy spokesman for Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, Latif Mahmood, has said that government has clear stance towards peace talks with the Taliban. Mahmood on Thursday said that peace will not prevail in the country until there are face-to-face talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban. This comes after Taliban earlier this week rejected media reports claiming the ruling council of the group had agreed to a temporary ceasefire that would eventually open the way for signing a peace deal between the group and the United States. But the group said that there will be reduction in violence. The Taliban has been talking to the United States on and off since July last year, but has always refused to directly negotiate with the Afghan government, which has emerged as the main hurdle to a comprehensive peace settlement to end more than 4 decades of war in Afghanistan. The group considers the government in Kabul a puppet regime with no real power and believes that negotiations with it would grant the government legitimacy.
Afghanistan's Ministry of Agriculture, Irrigation and Livestock has said that cotton production in the country has increased by 21% this harvest season. The development comes as government is trying to promote agricultural sector to create more job opportunities and to revive fields to harvest cash crops like cotton, where farmers earlier used to produce illicit crops like opium poppy.
Cotton production in Afghanistan has increased by 21% this harvest season Compared to the previous one, the country's Ministry of Agriculture, Irrigation and Livestock said on Thursday. The ministry in a statement said the latest statistics from 17 of 34 provinces showed that cotton or so-called white coal production reached 73,119 metric tons this year. The development comes as Afghan government is taking measures to invest in agriculture sector to further create job opportunities for people and revive fields in parts of the country to harvest other cash crops, where many farmers still highly depend on illicit crops like opium poppy. Poppy production is restricted in some parts of Afghanistan, but farmers who make profit out of poppy cultivation take Taliban support to protect their poppy fields and also in selling of the illegal produce.
A barber in southern India is offering his customers a discount with a unique condition to read books while waiting for their turn at his shop. The barber shop cum library has a collection of over 1,000 books.
A barber in Thoothukudi town of India's Tamil Nadu province has come out with a new discount offer for his customers, and the only condition is to read books while sitting at his shop. Barber Pon Mariappan has always been very enthusiastic about books, especially those related to history, but to his disappointment, people don't discuss books these days as often as they used to. This motivated Mariappan to this unique initiative, where anyone who comes to his shop and reads books from his free library, instead of looking at their mobile phones or other electronic devices, he gives those customers a 40% discount.
அலைபேசி முகத்தில் இருக்கின்ற போது நம்மளோட புத்தக வாசிப்பு எனும் ஒரு கலை வந்து குறைந்து கொண்டே இருக்கிறது. அதை நான் ஒரு மேம்படுத்த வேண்டும் என்பதற்காக வருகின்ற ஜனவரி 1/1/2020 இந்தியா அறிவிலே வல்லரசு நாடாகவும் வளர்ந்த நாடாகவும் 2020 மாறும் என்ற மாண்புமிகு டாக்டர் ஆபேஜ் அப்துல் கலாம் அவர்களின் மாபெரும் கனவு நினைவாகக்கூடிய ஒரு காலம் உருவாகி கொண்டிருக்கிறது.
Most books in Mariappan's over 1,000 books collection are in Tamil language. However, he does have some books in English as well. Impressed by his efforts, a local parliamentarian, Kani Moi, and popular novelist Ramakrishna have also donated significant number of books to him.
Tibetan spiritual leader the Dalai Lama began a five-day long teaching session for monks and devotees in India's eastern Bihar province on Thursday. More than 30,000 people from around the world attended the teaching session on the first day.
Tibetan spiritual leader the Dalai Lama began the five-day long teaching session for monks and devotees in India's eastern Bihar province on Thursday. More than 30,000 people, Tibetan monks, nuns, devotees from Himalayan regions and from around the world attended the teaching session of the Nobel laureate held in the spiritual town of Bodh Gaya. Addressing the crowd, the Dalai Lama explained the 37 practices of Bodhisattva, the path leading to Buddhahood in terms of mantra accompanying the Heart Sutra, a popular collection of aphorisms in Mahayana Buddhism.
This is a big special moment for me and a big honor to be here. This teaching is very deep and very for the soul.
I think the Dalai Lama is really given a message for everybody to understand. I need to understand myself to understand everybody and to respect everybody.
The Kal Chakra or Wheel of Time teaching underway in Bodh Gaya is significant as it is place where Lord Buddha attained enlightenment. A large number of people come together to achieve inner peace.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.